Hello everyone and welcome to the new course of physics. In this session we are going to learn about module 2, that is wave motion and acoustics. Myself Professor Piyush Tandel, assistant professor from Mahatma Gandhi Institute Technological Education and Research Center, Navsari, located in Gujarat. Now let's start with some basic fundamental of waves. The wave is a form of disturbance which transmit energy from one place to another place without the actual flow of matter as a whole. Wave motion is a form of disturbance which is due to repeated periodic vibration of a particle of a medium about their mean position, and the motion is handed over from one particle to the another without any net transport of the medium. Now we are going to talk about water and sound wave. So water wave or sound wave are called mechanical or elastic wave as they require material medium for their propagation, which process elasticity as well as inertia. Matter wave are associated with moving electrons, protons, neutrons and other fundamental particles and even atoms. Molecules all constitute these matters. So are called matter wave. Matter wave arise in quantum mechanical description of nature. Thus, wave are of three different types, that is mechanical wave, electromagnetic wave and matter wave. So electromagnetic wave are like light wave. Light wave are electromagnetic wave or non-mechanical wave, which can propagate through vacuum, or we can say doesn't require any material or medium. On the other hand, mechanical wave are two types, transverse wave and longitudinal wave. A wave is said to be progressive or traveling wave if it travels from one point of medium to the another point of the same medium. Now, wave on the surface of sea are two types, capillary wave and gravity wave. The restoring force that produces capillary wave is the surface tension of the water. The restoring force that produces gravity wave is pull of gravity, which tend to keep the water surface at its least level. The oscillation of the particles in gravity wave are not confined to the surface only, but extend with the dimensioning amplitude to very bottom. The particle motion in the water wave involves a complicated motion. They not only move up and down but also back and forth. The wave in the ocean are combined of both longitudinal wave travel with different speed and the same medium. Speed of transverse wave in the stream is determined by two factors, that is linear mass density and tension string and tension in the string. Now we are going to talk about some basic definition to understand wave and harmonics. So harmonic motion. It is motion in which a body move back and forth repeatedly about a fixed point, that is mean point, in a definite interval of time along a linear path. Such motion can be represented mathematically by sine or cosine or combination of both function because of their periodic action. These functions have period of twice by radiation, hence such oscillatory motion are called harmonic motion. Here we can also study this with the simple example of this rotating motion. As we can see over here, it is rotating in counterclockwise direction, and on the other side we can see its wavelength, and the radiation or the function have the period of twice by. Simple harmonic motion. A simple harmonic motion is constant amplitude and of single frequency is known as simple harmonic motion. Simple harmonic motion can be mathematically expressed as y is equal to a sin omega t. Y is equal to a sin twice pi t by t. Over here, the capital T is represented as a total time and small t is the instantaneous time. Or we can also write like y is equal to a cos omega t, y is equal to a cos twice pi t by capital T. Here sin omega t and cos omega t are called as a harmonic distortion. Now non-harmonic oscillations. It is an oscillation which cannot be expressed in term of single harmonic function, that is sin omega t or cos omega t, but required a combination of both or more than two harmonic functions, such as y is equal to a cos omega t plus b sin 2 omega t. So it is going to show something like this, or we can say a crankshaft mechanism, and this is the combination of sine function and cosine function. Now, center of oscillation or equilibrium position. In simple harmonic motion, oscillation move back and forth about a fixed point, which is called center of oscillation or the equilibrium position. Free vibrations or oscillations. When an oscillator is given some initial displacement from its equilibrium position and left free, it means initially we have some kind of initial displacement and then after we are going to release that force, right? That is, without any external force acting on it, the oscillation oscillate as a vibration with its own natural frequency or own natural tendency, right? Then the vibration of oscillation are called as a free vibration. As we can see over here, once we free the spring, once we free the piston, it is going to restore its in original position. So this kind of vibration is called as a free vibration. Next is force vibration. When an oscillator vibrates with the help of external periodic force with the frequency different from the natural frequency are called as a force vibration. So over here we require some kind of external periodic force, right? So as we can see over here, inside of the piston, if we are going to apply external periodic force with a different frequency, then it is going to be oscillate something like this. So this is called as a force vibration. Resonant vibration. When an oscillator vibrates with its natural frequency f0 with the help of external periodic force whose frequency is f equal to the natural frequency f0 of the oscillator, the vibration of the oscillator are called as a resonant vibration. Next is damped vibration. If an oscillator vibrator vibrates with decreased amplitude with the time due to the presence of friction force, the vibration are called as a damped vibration. Something like pendulum. Once we free it, it is going to be slow down and then after going to steady state in its condition. Okay, as we can see over here, if we have some kind of spring type system and we are going to release it, first it is going to oscillate and then after it is going to be in its original or steady state condition, right? Next is undamped vibration. When a simple harmonic oscillator vibration with constant amplitude which does not change with time, its vibration are known as undamped vibration. So its vibration are not going to change with time. Okay, as we can see over here, if we are having some kind of external force, it is not going to change with time, or we can say it is going to continue in its motion. Okay, so over here we can conclude our session by completing the definitions. Now in next session we are going to derive the differential equation of the simple harmonic motion. Thank you.